Today, I'm making lobster mac and cheese topped with shrimp and an assortment of different wings, and one in there is really hot.
And I'm gonna eat it all.
Oh my gosh. my nose is running.
Hey guys, it's Ken and Paul again from KBD Productions TV. Welcome back to the Ken and Paul Cook and Review. What are we doing today, Paul?
Today we're gonna do some buffalo wings. Actually, we're gonna mix it up a bit because we're gonna do like the roulette similar, but the thing is there'll be different color and sauces, so we'll probably be
able to figure it out pretty quickly. Which one's gonna be the hottest.
Even by the smell too. And then we're gonna do a lobster mac and cheese because so many people put comments.
Tons
of people. Love to see a lobster mac and cheese.
All right, so what's first, buddy?
I don't know.
Paul asked me questions. Like, Paul sets up stuff and then he asked me questions of what I think you guys wanna see and what I wanna see. And he said, oh, do you wanna see us preparing the lobster tails and the shrimp? And I said, yeah, because I've never prepared lobster or shrimp. I always usually buy it peeled and ready
and
to go.
And some stuff we've already seen before, so I just put it aside, like ready to.
So let's just start from here and we'll go around the kitchen. Tell me what everything's.
So I've chopped some fresh parsley. I've chopped some fresh garlic. I've got water on the boil right now. It has salt in it.
Right.
This is gonna be for boiling the pasta. The wings have already been blanched, so this is just gonna make it faster for us. So I just put them on a tray, it was straight from the restaurant rather than coming home. I could have done from raw. I was actually thinking of doing a barbecue. Then I'm like, okay, well, I'm baking mac and cheese lobster and I'm going back and forth. I can do it, but I figured if we're all just here and in the kitchen, it makes us happy.
All right.
We're gonna do the lobster mac and cheese and the ramekins here. We're gonna go into a kind of like a funky presentation.
Sorry, what's that called?
Ramekin.
A ramekin.
So, yeah.
Nice.
It just makes it nice to individually portion each little mac and cheese.
There are the three
This is a Frank's hot sauce, but we're gonna make a traditional buffalo wing sauce out of that. Ghost pepper. This is just a regular smoked barbecue sauce, cattleman smoked. And this is a habanero sauce that I made.
But we've already seen habanero burgers, right?
Similar. I can't remember what habanero, if I did a certain flavor, I don't even remember which one I did for that.
For the habanero?
Well, because
that's the one where you made it right there on the spot and then we ate it.
Yeah, but then I don't know if I flavored it, like did something funky with it.
I don't think you did.
No? So this might be similar to what.
Okay, so it's going to be death.
It'll be a death song.
Good.
It's hot, but it's not killer. Okay. We're gonna make our own blue cheese dressing.
Nice.
We've got some Gruyere. This is just a cheese I was trying to get my son to sample because he was talking about cheese that he loves, and I thought I kind of narrowed it down.
And this is Asiago.
Asiago, yeah. We've already got some carrot and celery sticks. I had leftover homemade ranch. We've done ranch before, so we're gonna do a blue cheese. And so we'll start with
preparing the feast. The seafood.
So this, I just quickly on the way home from work, grabbed what I could. I could only find frozen. So we're gonna start, we have a lobster tail, but we're gonna be removing it right out, but I just wanna show a trick. If you're in a restaurant, okay, you crack the back shell, peel it. Now you'll see when you get like a lobster, like a surf and turf, they'll crack the shell. What they do is they remove the meat, but you don't come all the way down into the end.
Oh, okay.
And so what you can do is you can separate the lobster meat.
This is fascinating.
From the shell. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna lift it up, but not all the way. See, I'm getting further in there.
Right.
Close the shell back down, and you're gonna fold it over.
How creative.
And then you'll see, I mean, a lot of people, you have a surf and turf, you'll see that on your plate. So they're gonna bake it, put a little bit of butter, a little bit of seasoning, and you'll have that served like that. But
right.
We're taking it right out because we're gonna discard the shell.
Okay. Thanks for the tip, Paul.
But just a cool little tidbit. Yeah, so we have the shrimp. So we find it easy just to grab the underside where the
legs are,
and then hold the bottom tail so you're not pulling. Actually, we're gonna
take it right off.
We're gonna peel the vein, but you'll see a lot of times you start on the thing. If you make a slice there, you can remove the vein. This one was fine, but we're gonna. You'll see a lot of places will saute when you have the tail on.
Right.
So this would be peeled, deveined, tail on, and you can buy raw. Sometimes you see the pre-cooked ones. It'll explain on the bag. We're just gonna pinch the tail, so we're gonna do something with the shrimp.
Okay.
Something funky like that. So we'll just go through and do. You want to try one? I'll hold the camera.
I think that would be a good idea.
Let me just do one more, and I'm gonna remove the tail right now. So it's already been. That's why. Look, it's already been. So these ones here, they've already deveined, but they didn't peel.
Okay.
So because
some people throw them on the
bus. Yeah, because I'm starting on this end. Because it's already done like this, it'll be easy just to go like this, just because the shell's already open. And then pinch right at the base of the tail, and you see it'll just slide right out.
Okay, wash your hands, then you can touch my camera.
And then, oh yeah.
All right, my turn. Like Paul said, shell's already been, man, I don't think I've handled shrimp like this before. Obviously, Paul's a little bit faster at it than I am.
And then,
so pull all that off. Uh-oh.
Then Ken's going
to
do it.
Why did I get the hard
Ken's
one?
Ken's going to do it while he's standing on the ceiling. Look at this. Oh. Oh.
And then pull the tail off. But there's still legs on it. I've got to pull the legs off. Oh, there was shell. I think we're done.
Yeah, it's a lot easier because they've already deveined the shrimp.
Let me do another one quickly. Well, look at that one came up. Oh, and then I wrecked the tail.
Oh.
Look at this. I want that meat. I don't want to waste anything. All right, now we'll let Paul finish off because you're obviously way faster at it than I am.
All right, Paul, speed it up. Okay, let's work. Oh, look at the lovely shrimp here. Much faster he does it. Oh, you fancy, huh? Not one more in there. Nice. Smells good, doesn't it? It was hiding, was it? It was hiding. We'll just throw this.
Lobster, shrimp.
Lobster, shrimp.
Lobster, shrimp.
Okay, Paul, what's next, buddy?
So we're going to saute the lobster up. In the meantime, we're going to... I'm just going to cut this in nice little pieces here. Is I'm going to get the macaroni cooking, and then we'll start the cheese sauce. We're going to leave the shrimp whole. Take a bit of butter.
Buddha.
Oh, look at that.
I thought you were going to put it in there. I was aiming for
noodles. We're not going to do that one. Just going to two things at the same time there.
How much? That's nice. Like a half cup,
Look at that. Oh, this is for you to eat.
Mmm. There is a butter challenge. Eat a pound of butter as fast as you can.
Eat a pound of butter. So at the same time, I'm going to put that on too. We're going to melt that down. Let that melt.
What's this going to be for over here?
We're going to make a roux. I think we talked about...
Like a kangaroo?
Like a kangaroo. I'm just trying to think if we did one before. It's just equal... I'm trying to think for what we would have done that.
What's a roux?
It's equal parts of butter and flour as used to thicken.
No, we haven't done that yet.
Okay. So we're going to do that back there. Because what we're basically going to do is there's different... If you go on... there's tons and tons of recipes out there. They have some where they use cream cheese and they're melting it and they're mixing different... I mean, you're basically blending cheeses. A lot call for milk. I like to mix a bit of cream.
Gives
it a lot richer flavor. Of course, it's not as good for you, but we're just having a little bowl of it, so we really don't care.
That's right.
Plus, it tastes better. Where was I going? I can't remember.
We're making that for the first time. You're going to make that to put into the...
To thicken the cream sauce, we'll be blending the cheese into, which goes get mixed into this.
So it's pretty much cooked when you put it in the oven. The oven's just going to actually bake the top,
yes.
Right?
So we'll throw this in. Put that there. What I want to do is I'm going to cook these separate. So I'm going to put the lobster in. And you'll see it'll cook pretty fast. We don't want to overcook it. It's a little bit of an opaque color. And you see
at the moment.
Right, yeah.
Oh, it smells so good.
With a little bit of salt, sorry.
It's a fast cook.
Yeah, very fast.
And that is a heat-resistant spatula,
I
would imagine.
It is, this one. Smell that.
Oh! Scratch.
Scratch.
Sip. So you're getting more butter for the shrimp.
We're going to do that for the shrimp. This is almost ready for the flour. And then roux, if you'll use a gravy, soups, whatever, you can cook it with the flour and burn a bit so you're browning it to add color. We're not going to do that. Look at all that delicious shrimp.
Oh, hope you guys like seafood.
because you're going to see us eat food. Huh. So this one, I'm going to put some garlic in with this bad boy.
Nice.
You don't use it all. Make it really, really garlicky.
Mm. Look at that, instantly turning pink.
Yep. Smell that garlic.
Who would have thought, eh? Like, let's put some seafood in a pan with butter and garlic. Oh, look at that. That like spiced it up. I mean, spiced it up by looking at it. Not spiced it up by tasting it. Little salt.
A little salt.
And that was parsley, right?
That was just, that's just fresh parsley.
Oh my goodness.
That look about equal to you, Ken?
Sure.
That's called a roux. It's a touch more. You see the consistency there? Oh, smell that. Okay. This will show you something with the shrimp. So see the opaque? Oh, it's hard to see in the...
It is.
See how it's opaque on the side, so I flipped it. There's a nicely cooked shrimp right there. I'm going to be taking these off in 2 seconds. I don't want to overcook them. But you still want it to be slightly opaque. Once it's cooked, you'll see it's white on the side. You still want it slightly opaque in the center in between.
It's almost a gray, right?
Slightly,
yeah. It has like a grayish, gray.
Yeah, like if you look in there.
It has to be all white.
So I'm going to turn this off. This is perfect. And I'm just going to set that in a bowl so it's not still cooking. I'm going to set that aside for now.
Beautiful.
Oh.
Beautiful.
How's that smell? Do a scratch and sniff on that one.
You can scratch it and you can sniff it. Nice.
Mm.
Oh boy, I don't think that's going to make it to the table. I just might have to indulge.
Eat.
Okay, back to the roux.
Okay, let me just mix this now. We have to open another bag of milk.
Mm. Yeah, Americans don't do bags.
No?
No, apparently every time I show that I use a bag of milk.
I wonder if that's just in...
It's just a Canadian thing.
Is it a Canadian thing?
I think it is in other countries, but for some reason Canada adopted the whole milk in a bag thing.
Yeah, because I mean, well, we can still get jugs, and we have in jugs, cartons, and
we have all three options.
The bag seems to be the most popular.
Yeah.
I'll open up another one. Look at that! It's a bag of milk! So we're gonna put this on now.
So that whole time that wasn't cooking, it was just...
No, because I didn't want to... If it was cooking, it would have been... the flour and the butter would have been browning.
Okay.
And then it would turn this... It would make it actually dark, and I don't want it to be dark. Because this will thicken as it heats now. Is it almost beer time?
It's getting close. So how far are we now, Paul?
Well, if you stop eating the lobster, we'll have some for our mac and cheese.
It's getting close.
I see Jen's little fingers coming in. Okay, so this has thickened up nicely here. If it gets a little bit thick on you, just add some more milk.
So and what would that consistency be?
Well, you know, you have cheese sauce.
Soup?
Yeah, like a thick soup. So this will be ready for the cheese.
Okay.
So we're gonna do two cheeses in here. I got a shredded cheddar. And then I'm gonna shred some Gruyere into it. So you just had a piece of this. There it is. I was like, I'm missing something. I'll just set that right there on top for now.
You're gonna melt that first?
Yeah. When you see it, then it'll start to break down and turn gooey with the heat. So while that's doing that, I can do this with the Gruyere.
Oh no.
Let's get down closer to that and slow it down. I was trying to find my other grater, and the kids emptied the dishwasher, and I don't know where it is.
And you could possibly throw in a big chunk, but it would take forever.
Yeah, you want to. It just speeds it up. So it's so fast like this. If you throw in a chunk, it's gonna take a while.
Approximately how much did you just dump in there, do you think?
Oh, we saw the piece of the cheese. I don't know.
I don't know either.
It was a
I just eat food.
I put in, so this was the size of it. I put in about a cube. Was that a half inch thick?
Yeah. That's expensive cheese too, by the way.
Yeah. All cheese is expensive. So we're just gonna let that melt in nicely. And while that's heating, I'm gonna put a little bit of Dijon.
Wait, don't. Too fast. Let me see. Okay. Got it.
Got it.
And that's just going to give it some super flavors, is it?
Yeah, just is nice. So we're going to mix this up. You see the cheese starting to melt. Oh, look at that.
Oh, throw that on somebody's face.
Mm.
Third degree burn.
Okay, we're going to turn the back of this off. We're going to strain that, so.
Oh, they're stuck.
Got a few stuck in there. It's okay. So we dump the cheese and that in there.
You need a big pot by the time you're finished.
Yes.
Plan ahead, people.
So just put the heat up just a touch. Just melt that faster. And we need some salt in there.
Did you put the Asiago in?
No. That was for just, that was a taste thing.
Oh, okay. I thought it was for
me. We just have the sugar and the... There, see how it's nicely melted there?
Because it was
there?
Just for me.
Nice. So we're just going to wash this one here. And then we'll scrape that in. Fold it all in together. So now we've got our cheese sauce.
Folding. There. It's looking mighty good there, buddy.
Mmm, look at that. Oh.
Definitely don't want to drop your camera in that.
Into the cheese. Look how nice that looks. And then you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to strain off a bit of the...
A little bit too much butter?
The butter. Well, because I want to reserve the butter. We're going to do breadcrumbs, like a crust on top, with the shrimp. So that's what the shrimp is for. So we're going to put the lobster in here. And just mix it in.
Mm. Make sure I get the one with the most lobster in it.
With the least lobster, because you've already eaten some.
I've never heard of anybody put lobster in mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese!
This will be my first. So which is a good thing.
I'm going to heat that up. And I'm just going to put a little bit more. This is very liquidy. You know what we're going to do? We're going to put that lobster mess in there.
Oh, nice!
Why not?
Yikes! Good thing I'm not going for a blood test tomorrow.
Yeah, you might fail. Oh, look at, oh. That smells like divineness
right
there.
This is where you drop in like a couple ghost peppers, just to spice it up a bit.
Yes. Check our wings, because. Oh, sorry.
It's all right. Yeah, all fast. I got to slow them down.
You got to slow me down. Slow me down.
Okay, Paul, what's on tap?
We have nothing on tap. We have it in cans.
Okay. Ooh.
Kolsch. And something you... Oh, you know what? Did I drink that other one?
So this one.
No. Remember last I said we're... Maybe I did drink it. No. Oh, I didn't.
Yeah, that's
I
one
talked
you
about it. I said we're going to have this one. This is Octopus Wants to Fight from Great Lakes Brewery. And this is Kolsch from Creemore Springs. I believe this is a seasonal one, along with this one, which I've already been...
We dabbled a bit.
We dabbled a little bit. We were bad, bad. Kolsch is a, it's a style, it says style ale, because
what
you can't use the name Kolsch for beer. It's sort of like getting sparkling wine, calling it champagne. So Kolsch is a region in Germany. So what I've read on this one, and I've cheated, I've already tasted one.
Oh.
The style that they do, this is a 4.7% alcohol. It's top fermented ale. What they do is they cold filter it like a lager to give it a sort of a different taste. But
all these things that
really clean, crisp, for an ale, very light drinking.
Let's do it.
So I know you'll probably enjoy this one. Look at that color. Beautiful.
Right up my alley for sure.
And a real, real creamy head on this one. I should give Ken a little bit more.
For sure. Why wouldn't you?
At the same time, we'll crack this one too. So this is an IPA.
Yikes.
Mmm. She's light, eh? Look at that. This reminds me of,
for an IPA.
This reminds me of, we sampled that beer. Remember the Cruiser?
Right. I'm just going to move that there, that there, that there.
So that you can see it all.
So the octopus one is definitely a little bit cloudier and more amber, I guess you could call it, or golden. So
I would say that's more golden.
This is
more of the amber.
Right.
So I'll...
Let's do this one first. This is the Kolsch.
This is the Kolsch. Cheers.
Cheers. I like it already.
I knew you'd like that one. It's almost, it's pretty light, like a lager. It has almost like a...
Fruit.
I was going to say like I'm trying to think what the flavor I'm getting there.
All natural spring water. Have you figured it out yet?
No. All I'm going to say is it's delicious.
It is good beer. Now on to the octopus head beer.
Let's go to the fighting octopus.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Whoa! Flavor explosion.
That one's like a super flavor explosion. Explosion. I'm just trying to see what percent this one is.
My eyes are 300%, I think.
Can's hard to probably because my eyes are bad.
That is like very what wood? Man. That is a very fruity taste, isn't it?
It's extremely fruity.
Extremely fruity, extremely strong, extreme IPA.
Oh, 6.2%.
6.2
And the Kolsch was 4.7.
6.2. So we'll put this down, and we'll pick up our other beer and drink like a normal person. Oh, so much better.
I like both of them.
Well, good for you. I'll take your glass.
Ugh.
And then I'll pour that in there so you can have your IPA crap.
Nice. Breadcrumbs? Italian style? What are you talking about? You're so crazy. Hello, everyone.
That was Mickey Mouse cooking breadcrumbs.
So we're just going to mix that. With a bit of butter.
You know it's going to be good when there's a big mess on the
stove. A big mess on the stove? Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So.
This is the whole presentation part.
Yes.
You almost need a smaller spoon.
I know.
That thing's crazy.
It is crazy.
It's like crazy.
It's crazy. So are you repeating after me?
No, I'm not repeating after you.
Ken's getting the camera right in there. I can't even work.
People like close-ups.
Oh, yeah, it was like a perfect amount.
Nice. You planned it that way.
And a little bit more for you, Ken.
Oh!
We'll set that there. So we're going to put...
That's what we're doing.
Yeah.
Paul doesn't tell me ahead of time how he's doing certain things, and so...
Well, because I want to be a surprise for...
But it's good!
...for Ken there, so we're going
to sprinkle it with
yeah,
a hand.
Yeah, it's just it's easier for me
to... It's not hot right now, right?
No, it cools very fast.
That's just going to help...
Well, the butter in it makes it crispy.
Smells good, man. Holy...
It smells delicious.
So Italian breadcrumbs and butter, and that was it.
Yeah, some people don't like the breadcrumbs. Some people do. Some people don't.
I think my mom's always made it that way.
With the breadcrumbs?
It wasn't until I was probably in my late teens that I had like a Kraft dinner type mac and cheese. We've always had traditional baked mac and cheese.
Okay.
My mom always did it in the oven.
Look at these. How many shrimp do we have? 2, 4, 6, 8. We got, okay.
Some of the kids don't like shrimp, right?
I think they all like shrimp.
Ah, damn it.
So, I don't think I've seen a recipe with lobster mac with shrimp on top, but I thought, it did
change
work
it up
perfectly. I did have, change it up. Like, if you got it, use it. Originally, I was thinking of dicing both in and then doing a mixed one. It's like...
This is better. Better this, presentation for sure.
So we're gonna
what do you think, people? Ladies and gentlemen.
You want to drizzle some little garlic butter on there, too? Just a little, look at... Oh, my gosh.
This is not in any way a diet food. Once again, we don't do diet food here.
No.
We might in the future, just for fun.
Well, we did the salad, Cobb salad.
That's true.
We had bacon on it.
That's where it went downhill rapidly.
And then we're gonna slide that in the oven. Look at that.
That is absolutely fantastic, buddy. Oh. I need like a oven cam.
Yeah. Well, because you can feel the heat just coming out of this.
Yeah.
What I should do is move these around too. We want to sort of
how
time
long we're gonna bake that mac and cheese.
Like 12 to 14 minutes.
And what's gonna happen? Is it gonna solidify it a bit more, or
it's just gonna it'll be piping hot. The top gets crispy. It'll just be
well explained.
Yes. Is that, did I get anything? Does that make sense?
Not really. What are you gonna do next?
We're gonna do the buffalo sauce. We're gonna mix up the wings. So we're gonna have a couple of different sauces. And then I won't tell you which is which, but you'll probably figure it out.
Probably, possibly.
Because of the coloring in that. So we got everything in the oven. Wings are in. Mac and cheese is in. We're almost ready to go. So we're just heating butter. We're going to mix. This is just a Frank's hot sauce.
So that's about, a half a cup of butter?
It's pretty much equal parts. So just going to let that melt.
I had no idea that there was butter in.
Butter.
Hot wing sauce. Buffalo wing sauce, anyway.
That's their secret. That's their little secret. See the colors? Look at...
You just wrecked their secret.
No!
So it's butter wings. It's like butter chicken wings.
Because butter is so delicious. Let's see what's happening in here. Oh, that's hot. Oh, she's hot. We're going to turn this off because I don't want to burn the mac and cheese, the top. So you want to do like two each?
Sure.
Two of each. This one I'll mix with this. Oh yeah, Marc-Andre's gonna try, but I don't think I'm gonna do the ghost for him.
No, I wouldn't do it.
My wife would hate me.
Why'd you do to the sun?
What'd you do?
To the oldest son.
So he knows there's a lot of sauce because the two younger ones will have this, but they're not gonna eat. They wanna wait. They're playing video games and playing. Like that. And then we'll do six. We'll do the salt. Do you want the regular barbecue? No. You want to just do hot stuff.
I only want to do this one.
Yeah.
And that one.
The super
hot. Well, one.
The habanero you have to
definitely do. Habanero.
Oi. Oh, that smells amazing. I love the smell of the habanero. I'll do some more.
Careful breathing it in now. This isn't going to be fun.
We'll just do two of this because this is this one causes stomach problems.
Oh, dude! Oh, no. Yeah, which one's which? Oh. I wonder.
You stand back and you can smell it.
So what's the...
And we'll do...
When somebody brings a plate of wings to your table, it kind of has a bit of a vinegar smell. Is that part of
the... Well, because the hot sauces are made with vinegar.
Oh, okay.
So what you're...
Because when I saw you making it with butter and stuff, I'm like, well, why does it still smell like vinegar? Because it's the Frank's hot sauce. Has vinegar in it, but...
This one here is just... This is a smoked barbecue.
That smells good.
That's like... I love that smoke smell you get from that. We'll just mix that around. Oh, yeah.
Okay, it's time to do the presentation, Paul.
So we're going to set up three plates. This is going to be...
Nice.
We'll just take two of each.
Oh, one. And that's the one. Okay, got it. Okay, Paul, blue cheese time.
We're making a super fast blue cheese.
Super fast blue cheese.
Because I forgot to make it. So we're just going to put some sour cream.
Oh,
look at that.
You got me in the hand.
Did I get you?
Yeah.
No. Now I need another spoon, too, because I fouled that one.
I'm not sure if we got the lens. Nope. I don't think so.
Some mayonnaise. Oh, look at... Oh, love. Look at this all crumbled on me. Dude, tastes like blue cheese.
That's all blue cheese dressing is.
We're gonna mix that in. We're gonna put a little bit of lemon juice in there.
Ranch.
I know everyone complains about these, but they're so...
It's just convenient.
It's just so convenient. Sometimes, time of year... Because lemons go, like, in Canada, like, certain times of year, they go brutally expensive.
Right.
And then, so you're like, well, why would I buy that? And I want to put just a little bit of salt in mine.
Knowing that it's homemade blue cheese, I'll probably enjoy it more than the stuff that they do in the restaurants, maybe.
There we go.
Done.
Let's eat.
All right, guys, we're ready to eat our mac and cheese with lobster in it. And we also have roulette that we did at Nando's, but this is going to be way hotter than Nando's. Nando's was great, but this is going to be killer for
sure. Ghost pepper is always hotter.
That's right. And we, Marc-André has decided to join us for dinner tonight, Paul's oldest son. So left pig out, and let's try this first, because I think we should end with this.
With the wings? Yeah, because we'll probably be... I know which ones. Marc-André, you didn't get... I didn't put a ghost wing on yours. I didn't want you to...
Oh, thank God.
I didn't want you to...
You said hot. I was like, wait.
Oh, no. Check that out, that, ladies and gentlemen. Whoa.
Ooh la la.
Mmm. Wow. I've never had seafood mac and cheese before. I could eat a much bigger bowl of that.
Me too.
Sure. So it's still creamy and a little bit on the... Yeah, just a nice creamy way. When my mom used to make it, it would be like... Almost like meatloaf. So it wouldn't,
oh, really?
It wouldn't be that runny. I guess she baked it longer. But the breadcrumbs on top are awesome.
Yes.
Oh, there's some lobster.
Mmm. Mmm, mmm, mmm.
I can see that the breadcrumbs and butter on top is totally adding to this whole experience. Mm-hmm. Do you agree, Marc-André?
Indeed.
Woo!
It's very hot still, man. I thought it was going to be cooled down by the time we set up the camera and started recording again. The steam is ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. It's a very high-end, classy mac and cheese. Like, I don't think you can get any better than that. Like, what could you do anything to that to make it even better? I don't think so.
I don't know.
I totally recommend the breadcrumbs on top.
Very well placed.
Yeah. I spit into a really big chunk of lobster.
Mm.
They're like little golden nuggets that you find as you're chewing through this temperature.
I'm still digging away to find lobster.
We made sure you didn't get as much as we did. Just kidding. It was random.
It all went in cans.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it's all for the video, all for the quality.
Oh, another big chunk. Well, it's good too.
Mmm, yes. I wish I knew. Oh, here we go.
There you go. You found one?
Mmm. There we go.
Let's move on to the wings. That's actually quite filling.
It is filling.
That little bowl, when I first saw the bowls, I'm like, really?
Ken's like, that's all I'm getting?
That's a snack, but I'm totally full off that. Oh, I missed a noodle.
No, oh, those breadcrumbs, yeah, man, I'm telling you.
Yeah, they expand in your stomach. So apparently I got the biggest piece of lobster and Marc-André's still looking.
I skipped out on his.
Never looking, man, never looking.
All right. So this is our homemade ranch.
Homemade ranch.
Homemade blue cheese.
I know Ken's a ranch.
Should we go for the hot one first or get it out of the way? Or should we go work our way up?
Why don't you close your eyes and just kind of reach down and...
Yep.
No, it won't work.
I know exactly where it is. I'm going to start with... I keep hiccuping.
The only thing I don't know is which... I think that's the habanero.
And this, yeah, because we had the buffalo habanero. I'm going to try this one here. I know this is the... This is the habanero. So this is my homemade sauce here.
This one with the orange on it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you can smell it. Ow.
Yeah.
And the good thing about eating your mac and cheese first is you now have a bone bowl. Ow.
Chew that.
That's hot. I wouldn't want to eat too many of those. Oh, that man. I'm like instantly heating up. Dropped a piece of chicken.
Oh, I mixed them up. That is
hot. You didn't have the habanero first?
No.
I did. And it's hot.
It's hot. Oh my gosh. It's hotter than
I thought. I was wondering why you weren't reacting to it.
No, because I grabbed a buffalo. Because if you look at these here, this is the, I'm mixed up now. This was the buffalo.
So it is a real roulette.
That's the habanero. But it's a lot. Whew. I haven't even had the ghost yet. I gotta put some, I gotta cheat.
You fooled me good. You said there was no hot points. Oh, no ghost pepper.
This will cool it down.
Yeah, I can't sauce the sauce, man.
You hot?
It's already building.
The habanero is a bit hotter than I thought.
Yep.
Oh, dude. Oh, my gosh. Okay.
I am not used to hot stuff, I'm telling you that right now.
I'm getting the ghost one out of my way.
Are you?
Yeah, I want to eat the other ones.
Your best friend, Shed.
Oh my gosh, dude. My tongue is on fire.
Leave a word in the comments saying hashtag crybabies. Can't taste the heat. I can't.
Whoa, pass the ranch. My tongue is on fire.
Dude, fast!
You want to put it on your plate?
Sorry, buddy.
Man needs it. He's burning.
Oh my gosh, I didn't mean to do this.
Oh, my nose is running.
Okay,
ghost wing.
A lot hotter than I thought. I gotta do the ghost last because I'm on fire, and I have a feeling that I gotta mix in blue cheese to keep the heat down. So right now, I've gone.
Oh my gosh. My nose is running.
Your stomach might be running in a second, too.
Oh, dude. Oh, the habanero. Oh, my. The ghost pepper is now killing me. Oh, boy.
My lips are just on
fire. And if you like, if you're a big blue cheese liker, like, you'll see some of the pre-made stuff. They put a lot of vinegar in it, so I find it very vinegary. I don't like it very vinegary, so I don't add any in when I do my mix, because I like that really strong, authentic blue cheese taste. So to me, this is the bomb. Although I am on fire. Now I've mixed up. Now I'm confused. I know this is the ghost.
Excuse me. So
I've got three wings there.
Pass the ranch, please.
There are tears now running down my eyes.
Is it hot? Did you eat the ghost?
Look at my eyes.
Oh my lord.
I think we're a glutton for punishment.
That hurts.
Oh, yeah, I try my blue cheese, yeah.
Oh, it tastes way better than any blue cheese I've ever had. It actually tastes like cheese as opposed to a dressing. Oh my gosh, that hurts so bad.
I'm on fire and I haven't had the ghost yet.
Oh, last one.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Damn. Oh, okay. I just gotta wipe my hands for a second.
I hate you. Dude.
It's funny when people say, why do you guys make everything hot?
That's too hot though.
Because we like it.
Makes for an interesting video, but my eyes are watering. My tongue is on fire. Come on, Paul. Ghost pepper.
I haven't even got there yet, and I'm dying.
Do it. Get it out of the way.
Do it.
Can I use the napkin for my fingers, or should I wash?
Yeah. No. That's what they're for.
I didn't want to put too much goo onto your napkin.
We want to use some pretty napkins today. Okay, here we go. I gotta clear my plate.
Excuse me.
Put that on Ken's.
I don't like the noise.
Exposed. There's some. I gotta eat this.
They're belching before they're even eaten.
Oh my gosh. That was bad. Real bad.
Mark, what would you say if we, I made your brother's smoked barbecue wings and the mac and cheese. What if you did a ghost pepper each for those kids?
They'd cry. They'd cry both themselves to sleep right now. After a 12 hours in the bathroom.
Mine's subsiding now, which is good. Paul, man, eat it. Come on, no dipping, straight up.
Oh my gosh.
We're getting more comments on the wings than we are on the actual meal.
You're gonna see a lot of, you left some meat on your wings, you losers.
Oh my god.
That's crazy hot.
That is. So, I can't even talk.
That was very painful. Like I said, slowly dissipating in my mouth, like slowly disappearing.
The,
Done.
Paul's like sweating down here. That's amazing how that affects your body like that.
Yeah, I'm starting to cry now.
My eyes are all watering.
Just finished the last half an hour. Oh my god.
That happened. Oh. I've got a problem. My face is on fire.
I'm getting a refill.
Oh my god. The heat right now. It's just going up.
This is this is almost a challenge video now. It went from a cooking review to a food challenge.
The
dude, you sure know how to hurt people.
So, the blue cheese cuts the heat for a second as it coats your mouth.
Yeah, and then comes right back.
And as soon as it... I can't believe you're so calm. I'm crying right now.
That's why I ate mine first and I got more food in my mouth to get rid of the heat. I was like that for a minute. That's a good thing. Milk.
Yep.
Excuse me.
Okay, do me a favor. Just pour me... just pour up my beer glass. Hang on.
Ken, any milk?
No, I'm good now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real hero.
Real hero. Just beer. There you go, buddy. Mix your beer with your milk. Okay, Marc-Andre, get in here.
The blue cheese takes the edge off.
That is like, seriously, the best blue cheese I've ever had.
Thanks. If... I could not eat 10 of those.
No. You'd probably either be sick or your body would just stop.
Ooh, functioning. There we go.
Working?
Yep.
But it works for a second, then the heat comes right back, doesn't it?
Yep.
But you didn't have ghost peppers. Ghost peppers.
The last one was habanero.
That was pretty hot by itself for sure.
The milk is so good.
It's funny because I don't even like milk. I'm drinking it to get rid of this heat.
Like the heat, when you first bite the wing, it's hot, but it's not. I just want to compare to a previous video when we ate the Carolina Reaper, and it was like an instant explosion of sheer pain in your mouth.
You know what? When I ate the Reaper, it didn't shoot through my mouth like the Korean fire noodles. You got to try the Korean fire noodles on a show one time because literally as soon as it touched your lips, it just like burned, and then everything in your mouth burned, and then it burned.
Well,
down
that's
your
what's
throat.
Happening now. Like
it was crazy.
I'm a ball of fire from just below my eyes. To right about here, like I'm crying, yeah. And I'm just like it's the.
It was intense, which totally takes away from the whole experience of the lobster.
So I'm gonna grow some ghost peppers and some reapers and some Ruga scorpions.
Nice.
I've just got a.
We'll make some sauces. We'll sell them.
One
on
of the
eBay.
Regulars at the bar came in and said he tipped me off to a place that's selling it.
The seeds or plants?
No, actually they have the plants
ready to go.
And they're ready to go. He did. He actually gave me some peppers last year. I made these guys some hot sauce because they come in every Friday for lunch.
All right, guys, we are done. The dinner started off good.
Done.
The dinner started off good and then turned into terror as we've been into habanero wings and ghost wings. That was insane.
I think I did it right, though. I did the, even though I'm crying.
No,
right
I
now,
think you did it wrong.
The lobster mac and cheese, I didn't ruin
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah.
I right. think if I would have done the ghost pepper wing first, I would have been on fire, and then I don't think I would have enjoyed the flavors.
Right. We definitely ate it in the right order, but you shouldn't have eaten the
yeah, ghost maybe should have.
You should have ate that within the middle, in the middle like I did. Anyway, guys, please, please try this recipe. Lobster mac and cheese with the shrimp on top and the breadcrumbs was absolutely
fantastic. The breadcrumbs,
fantastic.
And it just, it yep. gave it that extra.
Yeah, I was actually looking, making sure every scoopful I had the breadcrumbs on it.
The variations, they put cheese on top, so they put a slice of old cheddar or a different style type of cheese that's mm-hmm. actually blended in, so you're getting a different flavor, which is
whatever
nice
you
too.
Like. Yeah.
But the breadcrumbs, just that crispiness just, and
so
that
well
blend
together,
is, was really good.
Would you agree?
I agree.
Excellent. Would you have done anything different?
Heck no.
I guess the one thing you would have liked is more lobster. Because you seem to, for some
more
reason...
More lobster.
I guess maybe it wasn't fully
just
mixed together. And
through the whole thing, I'm like, not lucky, man.
And I got one nice big chunk, so I was happy about that, and then I made him feel bad, which is good.
Yep, just fits so well together, though. It was so nice. But then the wings were just a curse right after.
Yeah, the wings were definitely a curse. It was not a would not recommend. The wings were would not recommend if you want.
I could have been fine
pain.
With the habanero was really hot.
Yes.
Yeah.
But it was at the upper threshold of what I would probably enjoy. So like three of those habaneros, I'm good. If I was doing like 10 of those, I probably would have been crumbling on the fourth wing.
It would have been about an 800,000 Scoville rating, those wings.
Uh-huh.
And then the ghost pepper was the 1 million.
Well, the ghost pepper's 1 million. I think the regular habaneros are in around 350.
Really?
They're not up. It depends on the batch. Those ones are hot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway. All right, guys, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up.
Ding, 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 ding,
ding,
ding, ding.
And we'll see you next time on another Ken, Paul, and Marc-Andre food review. Ken, Paul, Marc-Andre, out.